Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Rhapublic livestream for this, the 31st of July 2016. Let me turn on the desktop audio, which is currently playing absolutely nothing because I forgot to launch the goddamn game. Goddammit, Ryan. You'd think by this point I'd have it down. I'd have the game launched in the background. I'd have its background music playing to kind of like, to play me in. But no. I've entirely forgotten how to be competent. Oh, good lord, don't download an update. That is not okay. I'm streaming currently. Oh, I don't even play Fall Showdown at the moment. God damn it. All right, let's get Don't Starve launched. Beautiful. Rhapsody Online. That's right, I'm online. I just had to log into Steam. God damn it, Ryan. Feels bad, man. Yay, updates. Hang on. Let me do that one. What up, chat? How are you all doing today? This is my second. Good lord. I don't want any blood in my coffee system. It is just gonna be the caffeine. Ooh. I'm very protective of this, like a squirrel with nuts. I ended up finding out, by the way, sounds healthy, it's anything but, Ark. It's anything but. I ended up finding out, by the way, why around the 2 hour mark, every single time, the stream starts dropping frames, it seems to be, that you live your life like a candle in the wind. No, it seems to be that, it's possible my ISP might be throttling me for consistent uploads at that point, so I might have to go have a conversation with them about it. Don't know exactly how that conversation would go down because apparently most ISPs just refuse to admit their throttling even when proven to be. Not exactly a confrontationalist, so I can't imagine I'll do too well in that kind of a conversation. God. Time for Rhapsody to get an IV for coffee? I need one. I would adore that so much. Oh god, I'm just thinking how productive I could be. I'd never need to sleep again. Right. Let's move to that one. And I guess I've also got to move this over. God, it must have been a while. Pop that up. I understand, video game, it's okay. These mods might break the game. It's okay with me. Alright, so, 109 days into survival, we killed a deerclops last time, if I recall correctly? Might as well skip the coffee and just down caffeine pills at that point. See, that kind of, moves over the line for me. I don't think I can justify that. The first thing they tried to break from us in college art classes? Perfectionism? Yeah. I imagine college art classes would be like, just have it done, and then when it's done, you can worry about how good it is. By the way, I did say on Twitter, but I'll say here as well, thank you very much. That's absolutely lovely. I retweeted it so people could see it as well. That's the fan art that Aurora did. Oh, this farm is not going to work. I need to spread these out more. Yeah, there's free leafy meat in these, but that's not really what I was hoping for. I need to spread the saplings out more so that the eye plants can actually get in between the saplings. Bugger. Do I want to do that right now? Probably. I need straight up liquid adrenaline. No, I agree with that one. That is 100% the route that I want to take. I don't care if it'll kill me, just as long as it makes me more awake. Before, you know, making me eternally dead for the rest of my life. Eternally dead for the rest of my life. See, this is the kind of sterling sense you can expect me to be making. With absolutely no caffeine yet in my system. Take the leafy meat and the eye plants will retract. Yeah, no, I realize they will. I'm just trying to get my shovel and all of the rest of the stuff that I'm going to need while they retract. Because I'm still going to need to replace things. So I've got way too much meat. Do I still have my helmet for beekeeping? Because honestly, I can't tell. Alright, how about first we aggro all y'all and kite you through here. There's my beekeeping helmet as well, though. Yo. When I said aggro, I wasn't kidding. Come on. Fight the lore plant. Oh, baby. Got him, chat. All the Gel Classes 101 was don't try to fix it yet, just do another. That's pretty much the way that I look at things like that. Pretty much, if I spend more than an hour and a half making a thumbnail, I sit down and go, alright, everything I do from it to it from now on is just going to make it worse. So either I come back and look at it a different day, or I'm done. That's it. That's just how it's going to have to be. If I recall correctly, I was actually going to let this grow into the... Oh, no, thank you. I was actually going to let this grow into the Spider Queen so that I could fight it. When and if I go back to college again, I might take some more art classes. I have never taken art classes in college, so I can't tell you anything about that. Artist guy buffered? Not on my side, buddy. Not on my side. 0 drop frames so far. Although that is after 1,000,001. Hey! Cool it. Cool it, bees. That planted there. That'd be on your end, butters. Haven't seen anything here. Beautiful. Always very appreciative when I'm accidentally right. No. We'll be fine. Just cool your shit, bees. Drop that there. Equip the Tamo. Rap, are you a Star Trek fan? No? Not at all? Have I even ever watched any Star Trek of anything? I think I watched the first film reboot that they were doing. That might be the most Star Trek I've ever engaged in. So I am definitely not a Trekkie, self-avowed or otherwise. Actually, just watched some tips or tutorials on YouTube. Those are helpful too. I've never had any additional art classes besides those that were obligatory. Oh man, caffeine, please get in me. Besides these in obligatory... Middle school, right. Eat the meatballs, go to sleep for the HP insanity, wake back up and eat that meaty stew. Hey, look who's here as well. What up, friendo? Which mods are you running? I'm currently running, bugger, can I actually see? Apparently not, all right. I'm gonna actually show the mods, because they have specific names. Go back to Adventure Mode soon, because that's the name of the stream. I'm well aware, I'm just redoing the farms. I've got combined status, display food, values, geometric placement, minimap, HUD, and smart crockpot. If I had to say which of these is the most important, it's probably just the top three. Smart crockpot, honestly, is mostly only important for the first time you cook something, and then you just remember it from then on. And minimap HUD, I don't know if I really use effectively at all. Oh god, English is so hard when it's late, sorry. No, English is so hard when it's early as well. I'm evidently... I'm displaying that well and truly. And there was a buffer, at least on my end. Maybe it's because I reset the stream a bunch of times before. Alright, your The Happy Few video, you sounded like you were mimicking Critical. So the voice was supposed to be like 50% Critical, 50% me. Although, maybe like 30% Critical, 30% me, and then the rest of it is entirely random speedrunners that you'll find on YouTube and Twitch that just seem entirely disinterested in what they're doing. Alright, let's hang these out to dry. This jerky ought to sustain me pretty much the rest of my natural born life. Can I even afford to? You know what? I don't need to redo my farm. Fuck it. Let's just go back into there. Speech pattern is more like Critical. Yeah. 100% true. It's the depth and tone of Critical's voice more than anything else. Where is our entrance again? Apparently all the way over here? No, that's the exit for this world, but that doesn't actually work. Oh shit! It's all the way through the swamp. Okay. Gotcha. It's my only language, doesn't make it easy. Yeah. I admire people who can learn English later in life. It absolutely astounds me, because of all of the different elements in English where it's like, here's a rule, except it, in the majority of cases, is not true. But it's technically a rule of the language, but you're gonna have to break it almost all the time. So, sorry, that's English for you. Civic says English is my second language. Well done then. You're exactly the kind of person that I'm referring to as I admire. The exit for resetting the world and keeping all the items you carry. Alright. I don't know if I want to reset the world and just keep items that I'm carrying. I struggle to even think why I would want to do that. I guess if I thought this world was done, but everything's available in this world. There's nothing available in another world that isn't currently available in this one. Because I haven't exactly burned my resources in that fashion. Alright. And where's... Did I go to the wrong area? No, it's down here. Cantonese and traditional Chinese. Damn. That's not an easy language to go to, go from to English as well. The phonemes are completely different. Alright, Maxwell. Let's go. Go, buddy-o pal. Here's a rule, except when we use the word from the other language, then we follow its rules, except for the other word we use based on their language, except with our rules. Yeah. That's English for you. Oh! That's a lot of spiders. So there's a few problems here. That is way too many fucking spiders. Hey, at least we actually managed to find Flint. I think, if I recall correctly, the first time we did Adventure Mode, we didn't find Flint for the first 10 or so days? Well, we're gonna have some difficulty doing a bunch of different things here. If the entire area is swamp, I'm gonna be very, very disappointed. I didn't even see the title of the chapter. Did it say a cold reception? Because if it's a cold reception, then I expect winter in 8 days. This is the world where everything else is swamp. Oh. Yay. Civic says, rip Pokevision? What happened to Pokevision? Did Niantic have it taken down? At the very least, they should fix their three-step bug before they have Pokevision taken down, if it is on them. Although, I guess I'm assuming it's on them. Probably a little bit of a leap to jump to. Well, we'll have to see how this goes. I don't like this much swamp at all. And it definitely looks like everything is swamp. This world is called Archipelago. The Antican Pokemon had Pokevision taken down, yeah. Alright. A slightly burnt flamingo asks, what Pokevision? Pokevision was, if I have this all straight, because I never used it. It was basically a way for people to track where Pokemon had spawned, how long they would be spawned for, their kind of nesting points, so that then you could go and track them down and capture them in Pokemon Go. It wasn't a bug from what the data miners were looking at, the three step? That has to be a bug, because otherwise there's literally no way to track Pokemon. No, to get to the other island, jump through wormholes. They said they had a script or something that always made Pokemon appear with three steps. Yeah, they probably hard-coded it at the moment for Pokemon to appear with three steps. Because my understanding of what happened, and I could be entirely wrong about this. In fact, disclaimer, I am almost certainly entirely wrong about literally everything. But what I heard is they used an outdated API that they knew wasn't going to be able to handle the strain somehow. So, they used it for the time being, and had it for launch, but then afterwards, just had to rely on removing tracking. Places spawn on one of six islands. They get to the other islands by wormholes. There is one thing on each island. Got him. Alright. I probably don't want to leave this island until I have a tentacle spike. And it's also worth noting that on every single one of these, I really, really ought to get every benefit that I can, craft everything I can, etc. So here I'm actually going to have to go through and make a full base. It's a little disappointing because honestly, I don't know how well that's going to do for... Oh, there's the Tangle Spike. I knew that was going to happen sooner or later. I knew it. If I can get to a full stack of both cut grass and twigs, I'll be fine. Got it. Whee! Run away. I was actually going to get the tentacle spike in my own fashion, and that's to drop 4 logs around an area that I know has a tentacle spike underground, because they still take damage while they're underground, and then just set that alight. I'm gonna create a forest here so they can burn it down for the charcoal. Because if I'm only gonna be getting monster's meat and frog legs, then I'm probably gonna need those. Just a hunch. We'll pre-craft the campfire. Definitely going to need it. Alright, my goal here is to try and get these to go to war, and that goal has already succeeded. You learned the tentacle thing from James Bucket? Maybe? If he's the guy that made the tips and tricks video for Don't Starve and Don't Starve Together, then yes. That is where I learned that. Oh, there's the tentacle spots as well. Use that to make a hat. Damn, every single one of these has actually dropped the tentacle spike. If I recall correctly, the tentacle spike is actually like a 25% drop chance. So the fact that it's happened every time is actually kind of insane. Alright. Let's cook up the things that are taking up a slot needlessly right now. Beautiful. I like that they're actually able to overwhelm the tentacles here. I'm always rooting for the tentacles, basically. Apparently Dota 2 has VR now? Like, does it have a VR visualizer, or does it actually have a VR mode? And if it has a VR mode, how? See, the thing is, here I actually want the tentacle spike to win. But yeah, that's not gonna happen, apparently. Because now I can't get any of the meats. One, two. If they come at me one by one, then I'm totally okay taking them out. Otherwise, probably not going to get them. Juked him. Juked him, chat. Scroll to the bottom of my games and it shows a category for VR and Dota 2 sits in it alone. Wow. I've only got Albino, Lullaby, and Keep Talking Nobody Explodes in that category for myself. Oh, I actually got hit by one of them. Damn it! I tried the preemptive juke. Didn't work out for me. One, two. One, two. One, two. One, two, and easy. Got him, chat. It is suggested that the first forest biome, you see enough logs, you see to get enough logs, cut, twig, grass, and flint to survive for a long while, because you won't be seeing some of those resources in the forest biome again. Ooh. Hey, Rhapsody, I know this is 100% off-topic for the stream. There is no off-topic for the stream, that totally works. But do you believe there is an ELO hell in Overwatch? I probably am not the best person to theorize on that, just for the sake of the fact that I honestly never really have noticed encountering ELO hell. So, my understanding of the idea of ELO hell is that you have a low matchmaking ranking, so you only get matched with people who are bad at the game, which makes it impossible to really pull yourself up. So I really can't comment on that, actually. It's entirely possible that it exists, it's also entirely possible it doesn't. And there are a lot of people being oversensitive about it. Thinking they better than they aren't. It is recommended that players establish a way to come back from or cope with insanity because it's inevitable you will be traveling through wormholes very often. Okay. I can do that. Alright, just keep walking past. Well, I'm gonna be well stocked for tentacle spikes, I can tell you that much. Alright, well, if I want to deal with my sanity, the best way to do so might actually be through feathers. Are you actually gonna fight me? Fight me. Come over here. Come on. Fight me right here. Fight me right here, mom. God damn it. Never mind. Evidently, I don't need you to fight me specifically, though. So with these tentacle spots, I actually ought to be able to get a feather hat, and the feather hat gives sanity, if I recall correctly. There's also the possibility of actually capturing these butterflies, using the butterflies to make a flower farm. But, of course, that's going to require me to have an actual base set up. Alright, let's start to find these wormholes, because we are pretty much out of stuff to actually scavenge from this island currently. Go back down. Back down again. I just want the silk, that's all I want. I need to be able to craft a top hat. I think I only need a science machine, by the way, to get a top hat, so... You should be okay on that front. Civic says I stopped playing competitive in anything. Yep, I stopped playing competitive. Literally anything ages ago as well. I just found it was more of a negative impact on my mood than anything else. Alright, let's map the edges of the world. If they are all small islands, I should be able to map the edges of this world before we actually go to the nighttime. Well, that was dumb. Hey, Rach says Grumpage. Hey, Grumpage. Welcome to the stream. I can't play competitive in solo queue? Oh, God. I wouldn't even consider it. Solo queue is cancer, says Orbital. Hey, Orbital. Sorry to hear you feeling under the weather, buddy. Look at all these fucking spiders, Orbital. Look at this. It's insane. Okay, that is another wormhole. So it looks like the majority of wormholes are sticking around in this area. Are there six wormholes on each island leading to each other island, or is it only two on this island? Like, I'm a celebrity, get me out of here. Do they regularly have challenges where there's a bunch of spiders and Wilson carrying a tentacle spike? Or four? Random people trying to be cool by playing Symmetra and placing teleporters on the edge of the map. Yeah. That's funny, like, maybe the first time you see it in a video, and then from then on it's like, really? I mean, we're just trying to have fun here. That said, I love Symmetra. God, she's one of my favorite characters. I wish I got to play her more often, because there is nothing more satisfying than... just tracking onto a Mercy and killing her in a few seconds, having her Reinhardt turn around and realize he's now fucked as well. Whoa, hang on. Stay away from that tentacle spike, thank you very much. Cooked fish. Cooked fish is about as nutritious as a carrot. I'm gonna have to disagree with you on that one, video game. Symmetra, absolutely my favorite character. It's so good, like, oh man. Specifically, I really like defending as Symmetra on... Oh, what's the name of the map again? Volskaya Industries? So good. Most competitive games end up with a toxic level of community kind of like this. Yeah, I mean... It's a difficult issue to combat. Toxicity in communities for stuff like that. The best way to combat it is just only play with 4 stacks or 5 stacks. Symmetra is really good because she at least requires some kind of skill. She's not a basic support. She's literally not a support, though. Like, so she used to give 50 armor and the 50 armor regen. At that point, I would say, sure, she's a support. But the 25 is relatively inconsequential. The majority of times, if something's going to kill you, then it'll probably kill you with a 25 extra damage anyway. 25 extra HP anyway, sorry. So the fact that she's classified as a support kind of bugs me. Ow. Because it means there's a lot of people who don't see the message down at the bottom that says, you know, no support hero, right? Because someone's picked Symmetra. So instead, everyone else avoids picking a support hero. They really just need to make the switch and move her over to defense. She fits more in defense with a bonus shield buff. Exactly. I mean, Torbjorn gives out armor. So it's not like there's no precedent for it anyhow. Yeah, my sanity is taking a dumping. Jeez. Okay, I need to start a war between things. Go! Go to war! Alright, I guess I need... Ah, tentacle spike, that'll do it. Go! Tentacle spikes! Go to war! Okay, beautiful. Got him. When using the wormhole, it is possible you travel into the middle of a field of killer beehives, spiders, or aggressive creatures, so be prepared to run. Oh god. I don't know if I'll be prepared for that ever. Okay, our forest is still not ready to burn down. I kind of want to burn that down and get the charcoal before I leave, to be entirely honest with you. Torbjorn is classified as a builder, but no signs of him being a support. That's weird. I mean, he's classified as a builder, so is Symmetra. Orbital says, how'd the Wii Happy View skit go down? It seems to have gotten pretty much the response I expected, which is the majority of people saying, what? Pretty much what I was hoping for. David Boss XD, thank you for following. Welcome to the Rhapublic. How am I going to boost my sanity? I do have the cooked green cap. Sanity boosting foods. Taffy is probably the best one for it. I wouldn't mind Rhapsody doing a let's play of We Happy Few. That game's not done. It's just not done yet. Normal raid plus solar flare plus zombie raid. GG, RimWorld, GG, another colony bites the dust. Good goddamn. It doesn't say link deleted? Yeah, because that's Orbital posting it. He's a mod. Mods can flaunt the responsibilities of what would usually be required by the channel. Alright, hang on. Got him. Nope. Got him. Damn it, missed it again. Alright, let's go to the wormholes, in fact. I am really tired of this world and I just need to find something else to move to. Because this world isn't getting better any faster. It is roguelike if you put on permadeath. That's true, but it's... Like, it's got a founding story to it. So... Like, it's difficult to talk about what is and what is not roguelike in this world. Is a moderator, they are not restricted. Exactly. Yo, what the fuck? Just give everyone mods so they can post links. That's a really good idea. Oh, that's a shovel. Thank you. Shit. Eat the spider gland. How does one become moderator app? Well, first, I guess, in Orbital's case, have worked with me for a year and a half. It's a good starting ground. In all honesty, there isn't much more need for more mods at this size of channel. 100% true, Hawk. Okay. Let's move up in this general vicinity. If I can get a koalapin, I might actually be able to feed myself for a while. God damn it. I really do not like this world. I'm actually considering just letting myself die so I can start with a different world. Because this being my first world, I have no gold. I have no stone. Like, a lot of the things that I need to actually start a world just don't exist here. At least we have Beefalo. We do have Beefalo. It's okay. Don't be scared. War! Yes, got him. Ow. One, two, three, four, five, run away! One, two. Now that's how you do it, Orbital. I tried to use Imager once, got my manhood stuck in the toaster. You really need to get that toaster away from you. You need to send a CV to Ryan 100 times. That's true. On a more serious note, Butters, not speaking for Rhapsody here, but I've ended up as a mod on various forums and channels, and normally it's just be active, kind, and calm-headed. Show respect. And be able to maintain the peace, and then randomly you get asked if you want to be a mod. Yep, that's pretty much how it goes. I would 100% agree with that. How am I going to get this sanity back, though? We can get a bunch of our sanity back by just crafting new things, discovering new blueprints, but I'm not going to be able to do that until I actually find... Hey, hang on. Feed this fire. Not going to be able to do that until I actually find some stone. If there was not permadeath in We Happy Few, you can just run in, start, fight with everyone, come back and fight again. I mean, you kind of can do that at the moment, though. I don't know, the game is, like, really, really, really buggy. The majority of quest lines... No, not the majority. But a significant amount of quest lines just fail halfway through because some character has either despawned or... set back to a previous checkpoint, or something stupid has happened. They're repeating some sort of a line and just can't actually move past that dialogue, even if they should be able to. Chat is heading towards ELO hell. Yeah, exactly. None of you are gonna get to competitive chat if we keep spamming memes. I don't know. Maybe that's the way to get to competitive chat, just spam more memes. How would I know? If there's no stone here, I might have to do something drastic. Because this is a really nice Beefalo world. But if there's no stone, is it even worth it? Memes can get you anywhere. Can memes get me a job at a Fortune 500 company? But that's fine, Rhapsody. I don't want to be a competitive chatter. I'm just a filthy casual. That's fair enough. That's the way to be. Just embrace who you are. Don't let your memes be dreams. Toto, that might be the most important thing you've ever said. Alright. We're about to engage in some incredibly pro strats. You ready for this? Are you ready for this? So, I'm gonna eat 3 uncooked monster meat in order to kill my character. We're gonna respawn outside of Maxwell, the adventure mode, and we're gonna restart it. Because, good lord, that was an abysmal spawn. That is a horrible world to have to go to first. King of Winter. I think this is the one that we did on the second one. You know, we've been here. Oh god, this one's not good though. We actually needed to be prepared in order to get to this one. There's living logs as well. Firestar blueprint. Ooh. Hooray, it's only winter? Hooray, it's only winter for the entire game? Not that good, actually. I'll be honest with you. Right. Let's warm ourselves up. People say I'm a memer, but I'm not the only one. This is definitely what John Lennon envisaged with that song. I'm glad finally there are people here to bring his dream to life. Okay, you can kill yourself now. But I'm fine. I mean, winter for 1,000 days is annoying, but not the worst thing I could have gotten. As long as there's a decent distribution of different materials on this area, we'll be fine. Alright. Guess the thermal stone's okay for the moment. I have to run away, dunk down a tree, then run back. Yep, it's 10,000 days worth of winter, so that's about 23 years of gameplay. That's definitely true. You don't think I'm gonna play this game for 23 years on this specific world? A 100% the plan, of course. Obviously. I've just got to get this thermal stone done. Alright. Make that campfire. Don't need the grass suit. There's a flint up here that I actually might fetch. Just in case I happen to find some stones. If we can find a stone biome, then we are going to be pretty much in good condition, to be honest. I don't know, actually. Well, I'm staying for that long, then I forget Oh, right, for the 23. Got it.
Meme for the meme god.
Blood for the blood god, Kalima.
Eh, we'll drop the ashes, we don't need them. Keep the flame going. I'm gonna have to pretty much just wait through the majority of the days, though. Because what can I even get done at nighttime? Alright, let's see. If I can just plant myself right in the middle of a bunch of objectives, I can get those done. So say there's a bunch of trees that are fully grown next to one another. And just sit right down in the middle of them. Cut them all down during the nighttime. What are the most important things if you start a new game? So, typically, I like to get at least a half stack of both grass and twigs before I leave the first biome. That's honestly just estimation on my part as to what I feel like I need, rather than any, you know, surefire amount of what I actually need. But I end up with a half stack of each of those, then I start to get just enough wood to maybe get a full stack of 20. I save all the pine cones while I'm doing that so that I can plant those and make a forest fire later so that I can chop those down and get charcoal for the drying racks and crockpots. Past that, you just need to go get a full stack of gold and like a stack or two of stone, at which point you should just be able to craft your entire base. Blood for the Blood God, Skulls for the Skull Throne. Pictured Ryan as more of a Slaanesh. Ryan impersonating Khorne. I'll be honest with you. I don't even know where that quote's from. Couldn't tell you for the life of me, I apologize, but it's something I know of, rather than I know what it actually is. Probably not worried about continuing to burn fires in this area. Well, I'll never have the golden kappa. I've got it though. See? Damn it. I tried, chat. Can't say I didn't try. Is that a dapper kappa? Have to look at that. Hang on. Cap of votes. Oh, okay. As if Twitch needed more memes. Now it's got election memes as well. Blood for the Blood God is the Games Worship Corn Games Workshop Corn Demon motto. Ah, okay. What's the best method for getting rid of spiders? Move. Alternatively, if you really want to get rid of the spiders, you can try and fight enemies that will fight them. So you can drag worms to them. You can also drag them into tentacle spikes. You can plant a lore plant near their camp and then just walk away. You can fight them one by one, but it depends on the level of the hive. That might not be a really good idea. Burn them? You can burn them. You can put down anything flammable next to their base, set it on fire, and walk away. I wouldn't recommend that one because you don't get all of the loot, or you can't guarantee that you'll get all of the loot without it turning into ash. Alright, we've actually got some food up here. And it also looks like we've got some rabbits. I can craft a trap, actually. So I should be able to make myself rabbit earmuffs. Crap. Put it there. Then I just gotta scare you to go back into your hole. Go, 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 go! Up, oh, got him. Oh, whoa! Hey, that's not okay. Yo, what's this? Bebog's blueprint and B mine? What? That makes no sense! My understanding is that bees don't make honey in winter in this game. Why are you giving me this bee box? Damn it. I didn't want him to run back in the hole. Raps, you all have brown recluses where you live. Not where I live. Grumpy says struck gold, but I don't really feel like I've struck gold here. No, 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 no. Never mind. That works, apparently. Okay, set that trap there. Oh, come on. You ran straight through it. Oh, sigh. I know you're hungry. It's okay. You're not going to be able to eat, though. What, I can give you some of these berries, maybe? Three. Alright. Go back home now. Oh, what? Overturned my trap. Rude. That one's gonna come back up soon. I'll just hold out and wait for that. Bee boxes don't make honey in winter, though. Do they? Maybe I'm just horribly wrong. Why does cooking berries make it more filling? I think for berries, it actually doesn't. Don't berries go from, like, 4.7 hunger to 4.7 hunger plus 1 HP instead? I think it just gives it HP. Alright, well, they're not going to come back out. Is there anything I can actually get done this night time then? Because otherwise, I'm pretty damn certain the witch is going to starve in this world. So there's actually some bees. If I can find stone, I can actually create a world. But if I can't, then I'm not prepared for this world either. I'll keep tracing the outside of the world. I just need stone and gold. Thing is, it doesn't really have long to appear. Because if it takes too long to appear, I'm probably just gonna die of hunger in the meantime. And that's not gonna be enjoyable for anyone. Especially me. That said, it feels like the whole thing is just a large woodlands and then forest biome. Like, if this loops back and we're still in the forest biome by this point, then we're pretty much certain that nowhere in the center is going to be stone. Or at least there's not going to be a large amount of stone. Which is pretty much what you need to build a base. Yeah, there's no stone here. Bugger. Alright, let's go find something to kill us. Just gotta get something to kill me. Dazor is now following. Welcome to the Rhapublic, Dazor. Thank you for following. Also, in SDV, why are berries so OP, or is this some conspiracy to make us all eat berries? Honestly, I need a conspiracy. Cute as hell. Alright, come on. Something kill me. Hang on, if I take off the hat, I'm probably going to freeze a little faster. Smelling is crap tonight. Honestly, I cannot judge you for it. See, this world is best encountered as our second world when we actually have a beard. Because with the beard, the full beard and the rabbit earmuffs, it might actually be enough to just stave off cold entirely. Yeah, I'm just going to let my character freeze to death. Where is this beehive? Try and get it to help out. So as you can see, this is some pro-level strategy here at Don't Starve Adventure Mode. All you got to do is kill yourself until you get the right opening world. If only I could take my Tam O'Shanter and my walking cane with me. I wouldn't even take like a stack of gold or something like that. I would just take those. The game is afoot. Kill yourself till you get an easier world? It's more kill yourself until you get a world that you can set up a base on. You really want to use the first island to prototype all of the different kinds of things that you're going to need throughout the course of it. Okay. Looks like we've already got some sort of a base set up here. Winter hat, I appreciate that. So the game is afoot. I think this is... You constantly get hunted? Also, have a look at this. All of the grass is gone. Yeah, I think the game is afoot. Is you just constantly get hunted by hounds, if I recall correctly. I could also be entirely wrong. Who knows? Can I fertilize these? Yeah, you need to fertilize the actual grass mounds. So obviously at some point throughout the course of this, we are going to actually need grass. So I'm just going to pick up a hell of a lot of poop. And I guess flowers, if I possibly could. Although it seems like it's only the grass on the central biome that is... Nope, apparently the grass out here as well. But then some of the grass is fine. I don't know what's going on here. Alright, let's make ourselves an axe. Three big old trees in a row. I can only imagine what's going to happen with those. Okay, can I actually get another... Shit, can I get another grass, please? Before nighttime? Otherwise, I am actually just going to die. There we are. Okay, so we've got a swamp over the other side. I do like that. We are starting to freeze, but it's only when we start getting to 0 degrees centigrade that we actually start taking damage, so until then, I'm not worried. Alright, I am suddenly very worried. Where was the other place I wanted to put this down? Well, apparently I've entirely forgotten where I wanted to put it down, so it's going down here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Got him. Oh, what? Damn it, now every spider's after me. I can't take you all at the same time. Yeah, that'll kill me. Alright, fine, do it. Give... The winter one. Not the one where it's winter all the time. The one where it's short winters and short summers. That's sanity draining, but it gives you all the resources you need. Alright, we'll try it again. Hate this one, though. The King of Winter! Let's take this. Both of these flint. Now, over there, we're gonna get our rabbit earmuff blueprints and this like. So we should make ourselves the rabbit rabbit earmuffs as soon as possible. Ice staff blueprint. Interesting, last time that was the fire staff. So it looks like there's actually some variation in what you make here. Okay, and we are two off being able to make the trap. Looks like we're actually going to have to rely on these traps as a primary source. Okay. One. No. You stay out there. Then you come back down. Caught by the trap. Beautiful. Can I actually get three grass before I manage to let my character die just to the cold? If you're determined, you can just straight up chase down the rabbits. See, but that's the thing. It requires me being determined. Excuse me? Place that on the floor, thank you, friend. Alright. One of these should get me the earmuffs. Fuzzy little bit of warmth for us. See, we're already more prepared for winter in this world than we were in the last, as of the thermal stone and the rabbit earmuffs. Sure, we had the winter hat in the last one, but here at least we know we're going to get the majority of resources. Okay, I started with 85. I'll be able to take down this tree and then three other large. Beautiful. Shit, maybe another large afterwards as well. We'll just stack up on logs. And I guess make a pinecone farm? I wasn't planning on it, but we do what we must. I've also got to worry about this thermal stone going absolutely freezingly cold and making my temperature situation worse. So the reason that I would actually worry about making a farm is because we are going to need a campfire pretty much running at all times. So having the wood to finance that is probably a really good idea. As soon as this thermal stone gets back up to the top, I'll just go cut down a bunch of trees until my axe is out. So that's going to be two full-size trees and a medium-sized tree. 15%, 15%, and 10% of the axe spent respectively. And hey, they're actually all easily here. Rabbits buffering time! I think the same thing happened on Sat, of course. Of course it is. Getting buffy here too. Yeah, no, it's definitely on my side, this one. Drop frame, 1,074. As soon as it starts dropping more frames, I'll reset the stream again. God damn it. Yeah, it's doing it again. Yay, ISP throttling. Yay, indeed. Alright, let's see if this holds steady for a while. Not a Russian Spy says, hello, I'm here now. Welcome to the stream, Not a Russian Spy. Good to have you here. And looks like we should be fine. Think I was off cutting down trees? Yes. That sounds like me. Gonna need a bunch more, oh baby. As soon as I say we're gonna need a bunch more grass appears on screen. Couldn't have asked for more. We should also pick up the green mushrooms at any opportunity so that we can fuck with our sanity whenever we like. I should probably start moving back to the campfire, though. Even with 11% left, if I want to pick things on my way back... Yeah, we definitely want to move back. Dropping! What are you doing?! God damn it! Shh. No one tell my internet service provider that I'm streaming. Shit, where is my fire? Oh, beautiful. It's still roaring, and by roaring, I mean it's an absolute whimper in the distance. Thankfully, it's still going, at least. It's more than enough for me. So the reason that we want to keep these green caps on us at all times is because this world requires us to go through a bunch of different obelisk passages. And those obelisk passages are guarded by basically gates that you can only open if you're at extremely high or extremely low sanity, depending on the gate. And we can easily manipulate our sanity just by using the green cap uncooked to go down by 50 or cooked to go up by 15. Is there any other area out here? Looking for a rabbit hole. Because then I could just place down the trap and kite a rabbit into it. I definitely could have placed this campfire better. Definitely could have done that better. Oh well. We're gonna need one more log to last throughout the night. Let's look at our world so far. We have one stone up here. That's good enough. We definitely need at least one. But of course we want about a dozen more. If that sounds greedy, it's only because it is. Usually I'd craft two pickaxes at this point, but I can't be guaranteed I'll be able to use both of them, so... guess I'll just leave it as it currently is. We do have the living logs. I wonder why it gives you the living logs so early on here. Like, maybe for making the Prestidigitator and then... ooh. That ice staff is actually... really close. So if we find a McTusk and we kill his frozen hounds, those frozen hounds are very liable to drop the requisite blue gem that we would need for making that ice staff. And then it's just spear and blue gem, apparently. Interesting. We might actually have significant combat potential in this world just off of the back of that. Okay, we're not dropping frames again yet. I'm really glad to see this. Yeah, it's spear and gem. Does it cost sanity every time I use the ice staff, or is it just durability? Or both, possibly. Okay, let's get these flowers as well. I don't really care about my sanity at this point. If anything, I actually want it kind of lower. But the flowers are going to be good for either rot or HP, depending on what I need them for. I can just keep them around until then. So uncooked, the red cap is negative 20 health. If I cook it, I believe it's plus 10. And I'm definitely going to need some health buffers at the point. Because that is not looking good so far. Is that a Dan's game in chat? Can't tell anymore. I'll learn them eventually. I'm going to need like flashcards and pop quizzes to actually learn these Twitch emotes. Oh, baby. Alright, we got him. We got him, chat. Gobbler, come back here. Chat, just trust me. Gobbler, come eat these petals. Go on, go on. Got him! Damn it, get back here! Gobbler, go eat these petals. Come on, come on, got him! Got him, chat. And I only lost two petals. Right. I am going to build one here. Hook up these drumsticks. You know what? I might actually want a raw drumstick, though, for lowering my sanity. That is interesting. Also, I actually should apologize to a slightly burnt flamingo. It does appear that the berries become more filling upon cooking them. They go from 9.4 to 12.5 hunger, and they also gain a health. I must have been thinking about seeds that don't get more filling, but they just get the HP. If I can find, like, one gold rock, I'd be in so much of a better position. It's either that or constantly try and force worlds that aren't working to work. I'm not gonna continue throwing worlds away looking for the one right one. Try to leave King of Winter. It's that kind of chapter because there is very limited resources. But the thing is, King of Winter actually has a few really good things in it. Like, it has McTusk, because it's always wintertime, and there's a few Warus camps about. So if I can actually get a spear and a log suit, I can go fight a bunch of McTusks and get myself all of the really, really cool things from that. I can get myself, I don't know, one or two Tam O'Shanters. I can get myself a... Is that it? Just one or two Tam O'Shanters? No, I can get myself one or two Tam O'Shanters. I can get myself a walking cane. I can get myself an ice staff. I can get myself a bunch of different bonuses from it, right? It's just difficult to start off. If I had a beard, this would be so much easier, though. I can't help but notice. Life is so much easier with a beard. This is a very difficult level, and it might take you more than three times to pass this. It depends on the number of obelisk crossings you'll get in the level, and also the amount of natural resources available. Rabbits may not be present at all, or limited grass in the sector. See, the thing is, we have rabbits, and multiple grass areas. We have decent resources, just not good ones. If there is literally just one gold, this suddenly becomes amazing, though. I think, if anything, the primary problem at the moment is lack of renewability of food. But if I just start actually using the rabbits, I'll be fine. Okay. Warm up by the fire. Beautiful. B-E-A-U-T-I-F-U-L. Oh damn, we can even make a fire pit. Alright, I'm gonna pre-craft that and pre-craft a campfire. I do need more traps. Shit, I can also eat, like, raw morsels to lower my sanity. Honestly, not bad. The worst thing that we have to do is map the rest of this first island, right? Just because we need to find all of the benefits that we can possibly get from this, and then move on. So we can't use agriculture. Rabbits won't be available in the next sector. Because if they're available in this sector and the game says they might not be available, then I have to imagine they're not available in the next sector. B-boxes won't produce, so I don't understand why we could find the B-box blueprint last time we were here. But this is going to be a problem for us. I just got to wait out the nighttime. I can immediately tank my sanity by 50 points. Well, actually, 110. Two lots of 50 and then a stack of 10 from that. Right, let's cook this up. And that is... we get 1 HP, but lose 10 sanity. Red caps suck. Well, at the very least, that's another way to lose sanity, so... there's a bunch of sanity tanking food over there. I'm gonna eat all these petals rather than let them become rot. There's actually no reason to have them as rot right now. If you have problems finding boulders, remember that those can be found in small numbers in forests. Also, gold nuggets can be scattered around graveyards or in large amounts near spider dens. See, the thing is, I don't have spider dens here either. Oh shit. This actually connects around to this side? This side has a spider den, didn't it?
Big. Biggie.
Now, you might not know this, but I can actually fight these pigs. And they'll just respawn forever. And die. Constantly. It's gonna be grand. Oh, go for it! That is more than okay by me. Take the silk, don't mind if I do. And may as well take the spider gland. Got him. Damn it. Was actually kind of hoping for something else from that. Maybe the monster meat. Oh, well. Okay, it looks like I'd actually have to recruit their help if I wanted to go all the way down there. If I could get the help of all of them, I could probably cut down a bunch of this forest. Would take a while, though. And I probably can't afford to get their help if it's going to cost me meat to do so. Okay, so it looks like this biome is literally just one big forest. That's kind of disappointing, I'll be honest. I do like that there's berries here, but that's about the only thing I like. Hey, what up? Come and eat these berries. Got him.
Idiot.
Oh, baby. What are all these flowers?
Stinkiest thing I'll smell all day in the Mermhead. So the Mermhead would give me, what, a fish if I broke it? I have to imagine it's fish. Alright, fine. We'll drop one of these and start going logging. This is pretty much what we're gonna have to do for the rest of the day. Just cut down trees and eat our lunch and press wildflowers as well. Looks like the main path runs through here, though. Are we sure this is the obelisk one? Because the obelisk one last time I was here was much more segmented than this. One, two, three, four. 140. Okay. Some easy sanity loss. See, I want the resources from every different area because it's my first world. So instead of just being able to run straight through... Like, imagine if I had two obelisk traps in a row that were both low sanity gates. In any other circumstance, I'd just be able to run straight through both of those. But right now, I need all of the resources, so I kind of just have to deal with it. Spiky bush. Looks like that's part... What? So that's got to be the start of a swamp up there, right? I've seen occasional gold nuggets scattered in swamps. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see. I'm going to end up with entirely too many logs. That is just strictly going to occur. At the very least, in this world, we don't have to make an icebox because our food is going to stick around forever as a result of being in winter. What up? Uncooked, that would drop my HP. Now it'll just drop my sanity, which honestly is completely fine. We're going to have to start looking at ways to increase our sanity after we manage to get through the obelisk, but that's a problem for tomorrow, Ryan. Today, Ryan only needs to worry about cutting down trees. Any other trees that are going to be in our vicinity during the nighttime? Almost certainly not. Yeah, we're actually starting to overwhelm our inventory with all of this stuff. Alright, fine. So we'll eat the cooked monster meat, losing the sanity. Only 3 HP though, that's not too bad. Beautiful. Use anything that is surplus to a current stack to fuel the fire. Come on, fight me. If I can't do anything else, I'll just fight during the nighttime. Doesn't cutting down those trees cause the tree giant thing to appear? Cutting down any tree can cause him to appear. Basically, there's like a hidden chance in the background. The further you are in the game and the more trees you've cut down, the more likely you are to spawn the tree god. I'd actually be able to fight the tree god, which is weird. And it would probably be a good idea, even. Because the easiest way to fight him is just get him to fight you and then kite him into fires. Okay, only 140 sanity left. So at this rate, I would actually be able to take myself exactly down to zero sanity by just eating the rest of my foods. It's called the leaf or tree god. It wouldn't be a problem, honestly. Plus, you can pacify them just by planting a bunch of pine cones in front of them. And if I have anything in this game, it's a bunch of pine cones. A full stack of 40. World is a lot larger. Hang on! Why? Why is this world so large? This can't be the gated one. It can't be. I've never seen an island this large before the gate. Remember, we mapped the entire island last time before deciding we were going to kill ourselves instead of going through the gate. We saw nothing like this. That's gold. That is gold. Look at that. That's gold.
Gold, always believe in your soul. You have the power. You're indestructible. Always believe it.
Gold. ABACABB for all you early console lovers. I am not familiar with that. I think the earliest console I ever owned was the PlayStation 1. Yeah, I was basically born yesterday. Oh! Well. What up, Chester? How you going, friendo? Honestly? Might be the best world we've had so far. There we are. I've got to get the koalaphant to spawn, because it'll be the winter koalaphant, and then I can get some nice clothing. It'll be good. It'll be good. I hate when these tracks go into the forest, though. Because it becomes basically fucking impossible to follow them. You gotta spot where's Waldo in this. You know what? I'm not following the track anymore. I actually just... I can't find it. Fine. You win, Koalaphant. We'll pre-craft the campfire. Hey, a totally normal tree. Nice. Very nice. Okay, I probably can't afford to take that much HP damage. Sure. Plant it here then. Damn it. Now, sort out our inventory here. We'll give you all of these full stacks. Start cutting down some more full trees. And then I should actually be able to make the science machine. The annoying thing about this, of course, being that if I want to ever come back to my science machine, I'm going to have to come all the way back up here. So we've got to be certain that we can craft the majority of things that we're going to want. So that's going to be log suit, spear. I mean, we don't have the requisite gold to make an alchemy engine. That might just never happen. I can't guarantee. Crockpot is on that list as well, and so is drying rack, but I'm not gonna have the charcoal for them without burning down trees, and I don't want to do that, so. That is gonna be difficult. Ah, God. Okay, I actually need more stone as well. Forest fires aren't about what you want, rather what the game wants to happen. Exactly. Thankfully, it's not raining, so we don't have to worry about spontaneity in that. So if our friendo here only holds full stacks and things that I'm not currently crafting, maybe you also hold the drumsticks and maybe the divining rod? We'll just check it. Okay, apparently I'm pretty close. That's all the information I need. And this is why we explore every single world. Otherwise, we wouldn't have Chess Friend, and Chess Friend is possibly the only reason to play this game. I mean, that and the endless hours of joy of actually playing the video game, but then there's also, I don't know, Chess Friend, he bounces, and that's kind of cool. I would buy the hell out of a chest of plushie. What if they sell those? Alright. We'll go back into the fire then. Bunch more in here. Chess Friend is the only reason to... Chess Friend's definitely the best reason to play, I can say. Well, I have made a horrible mistake. Well, here's the upside, chat. We're gonna have a lot of charcoal. Motherfuck, Rab, you are not Tato?
Oh, God.
Whoops, Kappa. No Kappa, I did not intend this. Oh, God. They actually are chest of plushies? Okay, I'm probably gonna have to find it and buy one of those. You'll screen grab it for him for ammo? It's okay. This one is actually my fault rather than all of the ones that, that were just lightning. That said, it's worth noting, Tato actually intentionally started his fires, and then just ignored controlling them. Sending that to Tato. Alright. I am going to get way too much here. You should feel bad? I feel okay about it, I'll be entirely honest. Thankfully, this world is not a world I'm actually going to be living in for an incredibly long period of time. It's not that bad. Plus, it's also worth noting there is another forest segmented over there. So unless there was something exquisitely rare hanging about in here, then we're fine. Oh, hey, what up? Got him. Got him, chat. 1, 2, 3, 4. Got him again, chat. Okay, this definitely is the area I thought it wasn't.
Whoops.
Ooh, okay, I'm actually gonna have to recraft a weapon here. Beautiful. Now, these nightmare petals, when they're on the ground, actually have a sanity-reducing aura of, like, 5 per minute. I think each of the petals stacks, though. So we should be able to just tank our sanity by just standing in the middle of all of those. So I'll just leave them there. I think I might have actually also killed the totally normal tree, though. That one I do feel a bit bad about, I'll be entirely honest. So you can ruin the world because you aren't going to be there long? What about children, Rhapsody? Think of the children. Honestly, fuck everyone who isn't me. So I guess I don't care. Yeah, I did kill a totally normal tree here. That's a shame. I should have just chopped that as soon as I got to it. Looks like the forest fire actually stopped halfway through, though. So that's good. Okay, we'll just have to see if there's maybe another gold or another stone or anything of that ilk along this area. So you say fuck to all your... What? No, I say fuck to the people trying to live in this world. Might have missed the joke on that one, friendo. Recraft this. Fuck everyone who's not me. That's how you end up with even more people who aren't you. Okay, that took me a while. Okay. Science machine. Let's get that down. Nice and comfy. Good. It's not out of control. Out of control is what we need to worry about. Apparently there's some more rocks over here. I don't know where these rocks are coming from, but they're manna from heaven. Please continue with the video game. Just don't overdo the fire. I'm trying to be careful not to. I made sure it was nice and comfy. Okay, I can now afford to cook and eat these drumsticks because I know I have a reliable way just outside the obelisks to reduce my sanity. Beautiful. Now, in the science machine, I already have a backpack. I will want to craft one in the future, but I don't need to worry about that right now. In terms of refinement, I do want to refine one rope so that I can craft a spear. And then I need to refine 2 rope. I don't know why EXE counts as a link to Nightbot. I think you can probably guess. It's the dot followed by another series of characters. Now we can get the log suit going on. Beautiful. We're pretty much primed and ready for combat as a result of that. For initial creation of a base, we need to worry about... shovel is actually quite important, though. Pitchfork and razor, not so much. If we're ever going to be doing this, by the way, we should probably do this now so that we're raising our sanity where it's not really going to be an issue for us. Tent isn't even that difficult to make. Just like D-Varth is also a link to Nightbot. Yeah, that's true. That gets blocked by Nightbot as well. What the hell? Get away from me! This guy trying to step to me. Step to me, you get stepped on, yo. 1, 2, 3. Alright, fine. Come at me in the night. That's more than okay. I'm just gonna collect all of your silk. Actually, yo.
Yo.
if you want to give me two more bits of silk, we are going to be in a stellar position. Bugger. Weird with block previously. Yeah, I've seen it interpreted as link, and I'm apparently it's not currently interpreted as a link. Honestly, as long as it's working, I don't mind. Oh, right, yeah, Nightbot doesn't block it based on links. It's Twitch that's blocking links at the moment. That is very true, Hawk. Okay, for drying rack, I'm going to need to apparently make 1, 2, 3. We'll go over here and pre-craft drying rack. I'm pretty far from being able to make the crockpot, though. Soon. Soon we will. And boards are super easy anyway. I'll probably actually go conquer that nest up there. Get myself enough to make a... top hat, probably. Do I really need that? I don't know. Couldn't tell you for the life of me. I do want the top hat, but can I afford to take it when I don't really have a full beard going on yet? I don't have any beefalo fur, so obviously I'm not making a cozy winter hat or anything like that. And I definitely don't have a beefalo horn, so I'm not making anything really good. Oh, okay, another totally normal tree. You know what? I'm not going to pass up my opportunity here. Gift horse, mouth, etc. Let's get that totally normal wood while we can. Okay, this should be the majority of the rest of the world explored. Fight him. No, actually, fight the creatures, damn it. There we go. The silk is going to be pretty important for a bunch of different things. So I'm more than happy to actually entirely exterminate the population of spiders here. BRB, need food and tomorrow's school starts. Ugh. That is unfortunate. 2 days for uni for me. We're back in the thick of that. You can tell how excited I am, can't you? I'm actually gonna... Oh, goddammit! My fire went out just as I was moving back here. Really? Actually gonna need to quickly pick up some logs from you. So soon, eh? Yeah. It's, a lot sooner than I would have liked. A lot sooner than I would have liked. Alright, I'm actually gonna have to start cooking up a bunch of this meat and just eating it. Thankfully, I should be able to replenish my health relatively easily. How's the uni schedule looking? Any clue how the schedule is gonna be changing yet? So Wednesday is gonna be, well, Wednesday for me, so it's Tuesday for all of you in the United States. That's gonna have to change. The Raptato show is gonna have to move to another day somehow. That's the only one that is guaranteed so far. It looks like there's a few other classes that are on other days that might have conflicts, but also might not, depending on what offerings are available and open. Yeah, everything's kind of up in the air with regards to that stuff at the moment. One, two, three.
Okay, these guys all actually deign to give me silk when now all I want is spider glands. God damn it. It's like they know what I want at the time and deliberately decide to fuck with me. Is that totally normal tree cut down already? I thought I did. Yeah, I cut it down. Oh, maybe I could dig up the ground under it. I'm probably not going to worry about that right now. Okay, just map the rest of this. God, we have such a large area to actually map. It's all of that. And then I'm assuming a big connection up here as well. If there's a stone biome in there, we are so set. If there's a graveyard in there, we're also set. Come on. I don't want to have to kite you. Evidently. Grah, why does RNGesus hate me? My deck consistently gives me either no win conditions or nothing but win conditions. This Hearthstone? Magic? Gotta be one or the other, right? See, if I put the boards on this, it'll start roaring, and, roaring is not okay. Roaring would create a forest fire. An eye bone comes with the chest. Oh, that's so cool! Also, that fire is out of hand. Are we gonna burn down the other half of the forest? The new Elder Scrolls CCG looks pretty cool. I've not seen much of it actually in-game. I think I saw their announcement of it, and that's about it. Can you get more spider glands, please, friends? No, you come over here, attack me. Beautiful. Spider gland. Nope. Essentially MTG Hex. Oh, right. I've seen Hex. I saw, Brian Keebler's actual promotional video on it. Actually looked pretty interesting. Looks more interesting to me than Jewelers did, to be entirely honest. I probably use charcoal to keep this going. Don't do it or Orbital will see the destruction you caused. You already sent him a link to the previous destruction, that's okay. Die. Oh, God. Stop it with all the silk! If we could make that beefalo hat, though... Obviously, we'd need a beefalo. And then we'd need to somehow conquer them. Only we can stop forest fires, yes, by shaming me until I don't fight them anymore. And he'll see more of it? Eh, it won't matter to him. One fire is enough. We didn't start the fire by Billy Joel. I didn't know that he was related to Superman. I can hear scuttering in the distance. Thank you. Never mind. Really hoping. Spider glands, please. One, two, three. Is that actually gonna finish off this nest? Yeah, it totally is. All right, I may as well take it out while I'm here. If only for the fact that Silk stacks to 40. So, I can just do it. Not going to cost me any inventory space. It'll cost me maybe a few swings. That's about it. See, if we lost anything in the last forest fire, it was just opportunities to get silk. Which evidently, there's no shortage of. Oh my god, stop giving me the only things I don't need! Game, please, why? What have I done? That one is still going to be full of enemies, so I'm just going to steer clear. Recraft this. I'm now running very low on grass as a result of all of our pre-crafts. Hey, that's some gold. One day Rat was asking for silicon, now he says he doesn't want it. It's 100% true. I mean, there's such a thing as too much of a good thing. I needed silk, and then I realized I actually don't need silk at all, even slightly. Now I want anything that isn't silk. And anything that isn't monster meat, because... oh, HP is not looking good. If I can fight enemies one by one, we'll be completely fine, but... fighting them all at the same time... I can't afford to do unless they give me spider glands. Which they are not deigning to do. I'm super tempted to buy the Chester and Beefalo plushies. Oh, okay. We should be able to make a permanent pit here. And feel actually pretty good about that. Okay. So we've got a swamp down here. Actually, if I could collect eight reeds from there. Okay, it looks like there's a total of 11 reeds, which is super annoying. But if I could collect 8 reeds, then I could craft the papyrus to possibly make a birdcage if I also manage to get afterwards 6 more gold. But I can imagine that there will be a rock biome somewhere eventually, just not currently available at the moment. Thankfully, we now actually have, like, a base of operations set up. Beautiful, that's another full stack. Cop that. Definitely don't need the ashes. I can make my way through at any point, but... if I'm not prepared to survive on the other side, what is even the point? So with only 6 stone, I'm actually relatively close to making the crockpot. At the moment, the primary problem is I've only got monster meat. What do I do with the crockpot, right? What do I actually do with the crockpot if I only have monster meat? That is interesting. I don't know what I'm going to be able to do. Yeah, we're not going to have any carrots around. The only renewable food that I can even see at the moment is those monster meat. I don't know. I actually don't even know how we're going to combat that. Right. Just dig those up. So you can dig up spiky bushes, and when you dig them up, you basically get the spiky bush in the same way that a sapling would exist. But you also get the sapling. If you tried to loot them, then you would actually take damage, though. So it's better to dig them up and then replant them than to actually loot them. You make kebabs with meat and sticks. See, if I just put in one meat and only sticks, is that kebabs? And even so, if it is, I also don't really have that many sticks. My filler situation is really abysmal. We doing some mad sanity loss at the moment, yo, though. This out. Beautiful. So now I ought to be able to create a few things that I really wanted. First off, let us pre-craft a... Never mind, apparently I already have one. Well, that's the most responsible thing that I've ever done, apparently. Let us plant some of these over here. I'm not even going to worry about making them neat. Just because they already look shitty anyway. I'm assuming I don't have to fertilize those. So I'm only going to be able to go and craft everything... Oh, God. When I go back to the science machine. Yet. I could remake a science machine. That's true. I don't know what I would do with it, though. Feels like a waste of gold nuggets to me. Where's the vibration coming from? Whoa, that sounded big. Deer clubs just spawned. I can run? So if deer clubs spawns over this side, I can tank my sanity, run through, and the deer clubs probably won't be able to make it through. Okay, just to make certain that I can tank my sanity, I'm going to take the rest of my green caps out of the inventory. Yeah, I think that was the deer clubs. That sounded big. The breathing in the background, that had to be the deer clubs, right? Well, gotta walk my doggo, be back in 10. That's the deer clubs. Oh, fuck. We have made horrible mistakes in our time. One, two, run. I don't know how I'm getting my sanity back, by the way, but this will have to do it right now. Oh, you're fucking kidding me. Is he gonna be able to follow me? Apparently not. Although it doesn't make sense that he's not able to follow me. Okay, so fighting nightmare beasts is just not something I can do right now. I'm gonna refine a rope. Make another spear. Fucking nightmare beast right next to me. Another nightmare beast on the other side of me. One, two... See, the problem with these beasts is they actually deal more damage. Oh, God. Like, I can't stagger them and dance around them. I step away for 2 minutes and you end up chased down by whatever the hell that was. That was Deerclops. Yeah, I'm actually just gonna... Yep. Do it. Eat good shrooms? I can't do it. I don't have any good shrooms. Plus, even if I manage to put down the fire, cook the green shroom, and then immediately eat it, I would immediately get attacked anyway. Because the good shroom, the cooked green shroom, is 15 sanity up, and I had to take two of the green shrooms in order to go back down to zero sanity so that I could go through the obelisks. So apparently that is the actual thing that occurs in King of Winter. The Deerclops spawn on day 7. I did not know that was going to happen. I knew that you had to survive constant winter. I did not know that the Deerclops was there. Fucking archipelago. Alright, shut up. Shut up, friendo. I don't care what you're about to say. Need a world like your first attempt? Yeah, no kidding. I never thought that I was going to be looking back on my first attempt wistfully, right? I thought that was a pretty rough go of it, but no. Turns out it was actually letting me off really easily. I guess I could make a garland pretty easily. Oh, hey, thank you for stopping. Got him. I think I'm primarily actually going to be using butterfly wings here in the early game. Hey, you found the wormhole. Yeah, the wormhole is actually right next to me. Really good spawn location for that. Okay, we'll take all the butterfly wings. Because we're also going to be taking all the flowers and just leaving this area as soon as we can. I'll take the shrooms, even if only just for filler. Now, I actually can't guarantee that I'm going to be able to get gold anytime soon. Let's hope it's the Rock Island, because only it has boulders. Oh, God. I would probably set up my base on the Rock Island, to be entirely honest with you. Right. Let's make two axes. So I've made the grass suit because the only other thing I'm going to want to wear in that slot for quite some time is going to be a backpack. And I'm not going to be able to make a science machine for a while, at the very least until I find this world of boulders. So, until then, I'm just going to wear this to try and keep my HP relatively steady. Also try and use food exceedingly sparingly. Probably only just before it rots, to be entirely honest with you. Don't pick all the flowers until you go through the why. Because they spawn the butterflies. I know they spawn the butterflies, I'm just not to worry about it. Got him. Whee! And you? Sanity and butterflies? Well, I mean, I'm never really going to be... Get him. Whee! That is a lot of butterfly right there. I'm never really gonna be trying to come back to this island, I guess. Just for the butterfly spawn, though, maybe it's a good idea to just leave them. Alright. Alright, I'll leave them based on that. Let's try and get some wars going on in here. See if we can get some cooked fish. Maybe a tentacle spike or two. Got him!
War! Huh. Good God, your world is a good for profiting from the demise of all these spiders. Sing it again, yo!
Alright. Hey, Tangle Spike! Yo! Defenders, please stop with the aggression. It is okay. I just want the Tentacle Spike. I'm only here for the spike of the tentacle variety. Hey, one of them launched into the other one. Really, I would have assumed there would have been another tentacle spike there at some point to cover my exit. Hey, you gonna respec into a full-on pyromancer for the DS3 playthrough? I'm pretty much a full-on pyromancer, to be entirely honest. Short of... I mean, I guess short of taking a bunch of my stats away from HP and chucking those into Int and Faith as well, I'm pretty much running as skint as I possibly can. As soon as I find the person that allows me to respec, though, I'll probably start considering that. There's definitely optimizations I can make in respecing. But I don't know whether it would be full-on Pyromancer or pretty much the same kind of hybrid it is at the moment with some sort of an interesting dex weapon alongside Karthus Flame Arc and then Pyromancy skills. I've been finding more and more recently that the Pyromancy is actually the strongest part of the run, which is, I mean, surely to be expected, but really surprising me. You can already respec with as much of your explored. Have I missed the character who lets me respec, then? Did you know the tentacle is the tip of the almighty tentacle? I did not know that. Just go to the right area of the Cathedral of the Deep. Do you mean right as in directionality right, or do you mean right as in correct? Because either way, I don't know where that is. Also, I didn't know that I'd missed exploring anything in the Cathedral of the Deep. I thought I was relatively thorough. Right is incorrect. I can type out instructions if you'd like. No, just honestly knowing that there's something there that I've missed is probably enough information to... guide me. Maybe. Literally the only thing you missed in the cathedral is this area. God damn it. See, I'd have to imagine that it is related to the bridges that I couldn't get up. Should see a doctor about that, but I'd have to imagine it's related to those. May I give one hint at least? Yeah, sure. Honestly, I don't mind. Okay. Pretty much done for the resources here. That said, I'm fine with it. I might want to get a shovel, come back here, and dig all these up at some point. Please don't light the only resources you know of. Please don't light the only resource. What? I'm not lighting anything. What? I don't understand the comment. I'm not really lighting anything on fire. Got him. Easy.
Got him.
Oh, man. Too damn easy. Stop staying still. You're just making it too easy for me. We're just a little short on cut grass, if you ask me, but we'll do fine. I also do want 4 more cut reeds before I leave, actually. How does a butterfly break your axe? It's a particularly strong butterfly, apparently. When you leave the cleansing chapel, go out the second door that you unlocked. Cleansing chapel. Right? The second door you unlock, the one with the lift that leads straight to the base floor of the cathedral, and take that lift to the left. Eventually you should be able to find it, figure it out, or find online subs. Okay, so it's a hidden passage. Damn it. If there's one thing that sometimes bums me out about Dark Souls, it's that in some cases there are things that maybe shouldn't be behind hidden passages. I know the idea is that the community works together to figure them out, but the community is also oftentimes full of hackers that just want to ruin your game. Thankfully, throughout the course of the series, we've only had particularly nice invaders. Although the majority of them have directly handed my ass to me, they've still been nice about it. You know what? That red cap is going to the ground. Ow! Stop it. I am only here for the resources you're dropping on the ground, okay? Thank you. Can I relocate cut reeds? It's in the rafters since I didn't think I was clear there. Okay. Good, good, good. I'll be able to find it from that. Carrots don't give you more hunger when you cook them. So we'll eat those. Oh, good god damn! That's a war right there. Like that. Run away. Honestly, that's going to feed us for quite some time, just getting these fish. They cook for 12.5, but then... Weird! Are they better raw than cooked? We can't move reeds, but there is a mod for that. Whoa, okay. I did not know that 4 of them appeared from each merm hut. Merms, please go back to your hut. I would like to actually start getting resources, and you are very severely impairing my ability to do that. That said, Hawk, I'm about 10 episodes in advance. Although the last episode that went up, 32, had audio bugs in it apparently. Which, I don't even know how that happens. My recorded and transcoded files are both fine with audio. So YouTube must have just done it itself. So I took that down and re-uploaded it overnight. So episode 32 is going to be re-released. With audio this time, because apparently it cut out at the 13th minute. Yeah, it has to have been some sort of error in the upload. Which is weird, for it to get all of the... I watched it before he took it down. Yeah. It's a shame, because I... That video would have went live at 4 a.m. in my time zone. So by the time I realized it was a problem...
Way too late.
House looks pretty small to hold 4 merms. Yeah, no kidding. They're packed butt cheek to butt cheek like tuna in there. Sardines in a can. I'm pretty certain this is actually the area that has the other tentacle spike I was looking for, right? This tentacle spike might actually get a good deal of them down. This one's gonna die, though. The one off to the left, that is. Yeah, I'm not gonna fight you. Not at all. Oh, fuck. You actually are kidding me.
Whew.
If you don't mind me asking, what are you up to? What boss did you last beat? Well, I mean, it's hardly a spoiler because I have to beat this boss at some point. So I guess it's not, whoa, okay, I did not see that coming. I guess it's not really a problem. Pontiff Sulevan. There may be a chance to find patches if you found Siegfried in the well. I did find Siegfried in the well, that's the thing. I spoke to Siegfried while he was in the well. I just could never find patches. If I can still find patches, if there's any chance to still find patches, I am very interested. Look at how many spiders there are. They're all just about to come to me as well. Like, as soon as they finish with that. Hop! Run away! Dip! Duck! Dodge! Dive and dip again! Good lord! Oh, we got problems! We got trouble right here in New York City. It starts with T and rhymes with P, which stands for fuck! Oh, no! Yeah, I'm dead. Two of them got me at the end. Weirdly, it was turning to daytime as well at that point. Thankfully, we weren't in Archipelago for that long. Ugh. It's the fault of the second spike for actually drawing them closer to me. You're dead? My dead what, butter? Where is my notification machine? Since then, have you tried going up to the tower behind Firelink and taking a lift up to there and its roof? That's kind of the way to trigger his patch if you didn't trigger his first encounters. I think I might have tried that. Oh, fucking Archipelago again. It's kind of funny how we thought adventure mode would be so easy in the beginning. Yeah, no kidding. Honestly, adventure mode's just been hellish so far. Especially today. I don't know what's up with it. We're pretty much just gonna have to use that tentacle. Wow. Actually, really good. We're gonna have to use these tentacle spikes pretty much to our advantage. Short of that, we are going to be pretty boned at all times. I'm never going to be short on money, at least. Let's say that much. I just can't remember if he'd been up the tower or not. I think after he didn't trigger initially, I went up the tower to try and force his trigger, because I heard there was a spawn point for him up there. Hey. Yo. I'm over here. I'm totally not baiting you. I can't imagine why I would be doing such a thing. Got him! Ah, oh, gobbler. Gobbler, gobbler, gobbler. And again, wormhole relatively nearby. I'm pleased to see it, but at the same rate, didn't help me last time. Think I'll only get a full stack of, one full stack of logs right now. I don't know if I really need any more than that at any point. Well, something to consider at least. Sucks that the correct way of finding patches initially is so damn easy to miss. Yeah, no kidding. I mean, in Dark Souls 1 and 2, the majority, I feel, of the quest lines, if you're particularly dedicated, can be followed blind. Oh. You know what? We haven't been in this world for long. Fuck it. What's just happening there? They're going after the fucking... Did I just create a butterfly farm? Oh my god, I just created a butterfly farm. Got him, chat? Did I just make friends with all of these hounds? Because they seem to be attacking everything that ain't me. Nope, never mind. Alright. It's another tentacle spike for me. Trace along until we get a tentacle. Got him. Hey, and they're in war now. Got him. Hey, too easy. Okay. Put down this campfire. Pick up another in order to pre-craft another campfire, should I need it. Honestly, I think things could have gone significantly worse there. You piece of shit, that was mine. Oh, yo! Video game. What are you doing? Trying to light my stuff on fire. Thankfully, it seems to have been very ineffectual for you. Oh, man. Video game's actually being really helpful here. Ura asks, when is the stream ending? I mean, hopefully never. Usually it ends an hour from now. Usually. I do love the glee with which you say they're at war now. Probably says something, just not sure what it says. I'm particularly excited that they're at war. I'm just really happy when both of my enemies are fighting one another instead of me. They're too busy, right? They can't focus on me. I get to fly under the radar. That said, we are quickly losing sanity. This is soon to be a very big problem for us. Got him. Alright, you know what? If they come in one by one, we'll be able to curb stomp them all. Okay, I'm particularly glad to see that spider gland, I'll be honest. Okay. That's probably the rest of the biome down there. Sucks that I have to use as much fuel as I'm currently using. I may as well cook and eat the things that we only have a single stack of right now. So 12.5 and 1 goes to 12.5 and 1. Yeah, cooked fish, I mean, it seems just to expand the lifespan of the fish. Rather than actually giving you anything. Chat, who told my ISP that I'm streaming? Starting to throttle me again. Or at the very least, we've dropped some frames. If you start dropping more, I'm gonna have to reset the stream again. Yay! 1 hour chunks at a time. Honestly, I've kind of created a bait here for them. The spiders initially go for the monster meat and then die as a result of trying. Works for me. Then again, if you streamed forever, I'd lose my job because I'd never go to work. See, that's a lot of people without a livelihood there. If we're streaming forever as well. Specifically, I mean me. Hey, hang on. Stop it. Thank you. You too, friendo.
Stop, brother.
Oh, yay! More hounds. Alright, let's go find a tentacle spike for these ones. I knew I'd forgotten about something. Whoa! Okay, that is ballsy play. Tell you that much for free, that is ballsy play. They decided to go fight the hound by themselves. Sorry, the hounds. The mound by themselves. Okay, I accidentally aggroed them. Alright, I didn't accidentally do it. I did intentionally do it, but the hound was doing it at the same time. So unfortunately, I accidentally drew them away from the hound. And that looks like it's another hound dead. Yep. Fire gem over there as well. That's another hound dead over there. Yeah, that's, I believe, all of the hounds. We found butter! That's like a 2% drop from butterflies. It's really rare, by the way, butter. So, if you're wondering why the happiness, it's quite rare, in fact. Now I just need to remember any of the recipes that have butter in them. That said, I'm probably not going to be able to actually set up any camp kitchen here. Please die. Thank you. What's it used for? It's used for making some of the most nutritious recipes in the game. But on top of that, just by base, it gives you 40 HP and 25 hunger. Which is better than most recipes that heal you give you in terms of HP. So it's just some really effective HP. Butterflies are really good for that. Okay. Boom. And we're entirely back on top. I'll also take all of these. I'm not gonna bother with the hound's teeth. As much as I could, I'm just not gonna bother with them. Alright, you win. These two don't- never mind. Apparently, I'm only getting one of them. Look at my name, I am rare. See, Butter versus Butter Sky Gaming. It's close, but actually, I think you'll find at the start of the stream that you said you are Flowey. Okay, I might just need all of the rest of the flint here until I find the boulder world. Not really that much I can do right now, though. Okay, let's get two full stacks of logs so that I can craft anything I want via them. At the same time, we'll get all of the grass and saplings possible. And as soon as we find the thing that's available on this island, and that's actually a technical term, the thing, we want the ring thing, crank thing, box thing, etc. As soon as we find the thing that's available on this island, we'll just move. That's interesting. Maybe I actually take some pine cones with me to the next island to try and create something that I can put down. I said that to the guy that said, "Hey, I am," and I added Flowey. I was referencing. I know what you're referencing, buddy. Played Undertale. It's a good game. I got particularly frustrated with Undertale when I was playing it because it contravenes its own, like, it sets up its own design standard and then constantly contravenes it, but it goes against it in a way that is strictly negative, I feel, near the end of the first run if you're trying to do it pacifist, but overall I can see that that game is incredible. I can't imagine I'm going to get grass on that many other islands, so I should just take it all while I can. 10 out of 10 IGN review? I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if it did get 10 out of 10 in IGN for review. Honestly, at this point, that silk is going to be going towards making a top hat for keeping myself sane while I hop through all of the... Excuse me. While I hop through all of the requisite wormholes. These butterfly wings are lasting for a lot longer than I thought they were going to be entirely honest with you. What do I even want to drop? Not the flint. Shit. It might actually be the butter. I can't afford to have butter just taking up a stack of my inventory currently. It's not important enough to do that. It did, and it got a few Game of the Year trophies. I'm not surprised, to be entirely honest. It's a really good game. I really like the current generation of just indie developers with a single design philosophy going ahead and making their own game. Like, Toby Fox made almost every single thing in Undertale, from the music to the design and the animations. My understanding is the only thing in the game that he didn't make was the animations and character sprites for Tammy, if I recall correctly. And then, of course, there's Barone. What's his name? Adam Barone? Tony Barone? Concerned Ape, right? Who made Stardew Valley all by himself as well. I mean, obviously the original example is the original incarnations of Minecraft. Although it's hardly true anymore that that's made by one person. It's just really good to see, because you get to see, like, more purity of idea rather than the idea getting diluted by a bunch and bunch of different hands in the pot at the same time. Viking says, hello, hello, Tyken love. That a... Oh, it is a Better Twitch TV emote. Hey, Tyken. Welcome to the stream. Doing Don't Starve Adventure Mode currently. Trying to make my way off this first bloody island, to be entirely honest with you. Cutting down 2 more trees should get me to my requisite amount of wood. Past that, it's just make sure I've got all of the twigs and the grass available. Likely more politics with more folks rather than having full control. I mean, sure, but like the impact of having entire creative direction, like the purity of your creative direction kind of being maintained because you're the only person in charge of maintaining it, can't really be understated. Is this the Steam version or the GOG version? This is the Steam version. Do they significantly differ? Come on, baby. Get down. Got him. Okay. Got our full stacks. Get the rest of whatever is available on this island and leave. Especially if we can find... No big difference, I was just curious. Oh, that's fine. Especially if we can find a bunch of more cut reed, silk, lint. That might actually be it for my concerns. I can also probably afford to just replace the tentacle spike. Nope. Don't spank my butt, mister. Thank you. The maximum amount of cut reeds that I'm going to need with the character I'm playing is just 8. And that's to make 2 papyrus so that I can make a birdcage, but that's also going to require a absolute assload of gold. Really, the only big difference made here is silk, and that's just that I'm going to need 4 for a winter hat, and then 6 for a top hat. And then if I want to make a beekeeper's hat and a net, I'm going to need more. I've only just realized I've not left space for all of the rest of the stuff that I need as well. For example, most specifically, the thing that's available on the island. And again, thing being a technical term. The ring thing, box thing, whatever it is. One of them is available here. I'm just going to have to get it. I may as well pull out the divining rod if I'm trying to find it. Signal is very faint, apparently. Now, Ryan, try and stay away from the enemies. You've learned your lesson last time, hopefully. They will gladly hand your shit to you. Those are blue mushrooms. Those are really good, actually. I might come back for them during the nighttime. We'll have to see. Is that another blue mushroom? Shit. That's actually appealing enough to possibly stick around here another night. Even if I did manage to miraculously find the ring thing. Have you jumped through the wormhole? Not yet. I haven't yet found the thing available on this island. It's my primary concern at the moment. Gotta be in the center of this map, right? The divining rod is not happy with me. But my understanding is there's one in every single map. Oh shit, this map is a lot larger than I thought. Okay, this might explain what's going on here. Okay, if they're off fighting down there, I can quickly jump in, get this silk and this spider gland. Beautiful, run out. Non-combat style. Dun dun. Dun 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 dun. That's... It was supposed to be the, It was supposed to be the Mission Impossible, but it became, are you ready for this? Dun 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 dun. Hope Rhapsody doesn't die, fingers crossed. I hope so too. I'll be honest with you. It would be a real bastard to die every single time I try and actually make a serious attempt at the world.
and give it a real go. Okay, they're all still going down there. I'm going to drop this tentacle spike in favor of the next one that I found. I should be able to camp here without too many problems. Oh, okay. Try not to fight, Ryan. Nothing worth getting in a war over. That's okay. Just let the spider walk away. He's just coming to check you out. Smell the area, make sure that you don't smell like fear, otherwise he'll attack. Don't do a battle cry and come near me. Please don't do that. Even if he dies, 13 out of 10, 15 out of 10, would recommend. My death senses are tingling? Your death senses are wrong. I'll be fine. If I recall correctly, last time we actually found Chester on the extremities of this map. Was that this map? Actually, I can't recall. Alright, go back to your bases. Unfortunately, this also means the blue mushrooms have gone back to theirs. Oh, that's not good. Thank you for going back down. You know what? That's good enough. I don't need the rest of those. Honestly, just needed the silk. Leave the merms to go about their own business here. I'm not even going to bother getting the fish. Even though I hear you can make something called salmon branch. That's what I keep being told by Grumpage. Hey, one silk. Get out of there. That more silk over there? Definitely is. Wait, say that again. I pressed backspace and went to a new tab. The death sensors shouldn't be tingling. I'm fine. Is that a large enough gap for me to have missed Chester in? It actually might be. Alright, fine. We'll go back and check, just in case. So apparently there's six islands total. If it takes me 4 days to explore an island, then not honestly going to be that bad. Okay. At the very least, now I have the peace of mind knowing that I haven't left Chester behind. Yet. I can't guarantee I'm not going to leave him behind in the future, but I haven't done it yet. There's five tings up? Okay. That'll make it a little easier then. Makes it only 20 days for me to explore everything. Honestly, I don't think I'll make the Feather Hat. The Feather Hat is sanity, sure, but it's going to require me catching a bunch of birds. Which actually requires me making a bunch of bird traps. And I need varied birds as well, don't I, for that? I can't even see what it is here. Nice hits. Walk the thin line on the inside. Beautiful. Oh, my bad. Made a misstep. We'll be okay, though. Thankfully, they're all tier 1 dens. I just don't want to stay here until there is a spider queen going around. That seems like it might be a poor idea for my long-term plan of survival.
Okay, and we are pretty much done with this half of the map. And we move on. I might be able to free up this roasted berry inventory slot relatively soon. Only two more of those to eat. Tentacle spike at 100%, so is the fire staff. Yeah, it's gotta be that or the axe that I drop. In fact, it's almost certainly the axe and the roasted berries that get dropped. Can I plant a pine cone on this terrain? You know what? Science time. Apparently I can. So that means that I will be able to grow trees no matter where I go. That's comforting to know. Means even if I go to the rock biome, I'm not completely lacking the ability to get logs. Otherwise I would be. Okay, this is a relatively small biome. Beautiful. As I had to kind of expect. Although, I'm still not getting any pings off this divining rod. So it seems... Hang on, let me unequip and re-equip it. Signal is very faint. It seems maybe there's nothing on the first island? See, because there is the... ring thing, box thing, crank thing, metal potato thing, and then there's the plate upon which you place it all. Really? Look at all this fucking beard hair! Is that enough to make an effigy? I don't know if that's enough beard hair to make an effigy. I don't know if I want to make an effigy. All I know is I am lighting this gunpowder from afar. We are just doing that. Do it! Alright, apparently I can't. I can't carry more stuff, I'm being told, as I try and use it. Oh, nope, run away. Don't need those spankins. Fine, we'll drop the fire staff. World is just full of fire staffs. I don't know really if a meat effigy would actually help me out here. But yeah, it appears that there's actually nothing on this base island. Really frustrating, unfortunately. Takes four bead to make a meat effigy. Beautiful. Yeah, I'm being led to believe that there is nothing here on the first island. Signal is very, very faint. It's always very faint, though. Guess I can cut this down, actually. Run through the wormhole? Yeah. Alright. I was wondering if maybe I wanted to try and map that little sliver there. Hey, Rhapsody, are you playing Pokemon Go where you're from? Yeah, I am, actually. I'm not particularly high level. I think I'm 8 at the moment or something similar to that. But, yeah, I'm playing it from time to time. Honestly... I live a relatively sedentary lifestyle, so it's not particularly for me. When I'm back in uni, I imagine I'll just be roaming the campus, though, in breaks between lectures and things like that. Plus, I gotta get a bunch of Kangaskhan so that I can trade them to people. Any international student coming over, like, oh, I've got Mr. Mime, because I'm coming from North America. And I'm like, well, I've got Kangaskhan, because I've been around in Australia for a while. Want to trade? I gotta get all those exclusives, man. Sanity's still an issue, but if we're leaving this island and we're never coming back, which does seem to be the case, I may as well pick up and eat all of these flowers. Ah, shit. The butterfly wings are going stale, unfortunately. And of course, I have to imagine you can't cook them. Strummer, it's actually Taurus in North America. Is it Mr. Mime in Asia then? But you're right, it is. It's Taurus in North America. I actually knew that in the back of my head somewhere. I don't know why I said the wrong thing then. Must be Mr. Mime in the Asian region then. What are the other gated ones? Or is it just those three? You cannot cook butterflies, yeah, I'd have to imagine. Europe. Does Europe have Mr. Mime and I'm just horribly wrong? Oh, baby. Got him. I mean, there's hounds mounds over there. Those are gonna be shitty. But we actually managed to get pretty much what we wanted here. A far-fetched is Japan, okay. That makes a lot of sense. Or at least sounds familiar. Alright. Let's drop the things that we're not going to be using currently. And I think I already have a stack of flint, so it should just be those. Alright. 2, 3, 4. 5, 6. Run away. Oh shit, did they just chase you forever? I thought they... Yeah, they went back home. Go back home. Go back home! What's wrong with you? It's your home! Apparently the exclusives can be hatched from eggs as well. Can they only be hatched from eggs in the area? Butters Guy asks, how do you have a desert? Honestly, I have no clue. This, the base world that I started did not have Reign of Giants. So, I don't know why I now have Reign of Giants content here, but, yeah, the desert biome was found in the Reign of Giants DLC. I'm familiar. I'm not gonna look a gift horse in the mouth on this one. I'm gonna take it and be pretty happy about it. The desert is where I would like to set up a biome anyway. Set up a biome. Set up a... camp anyhow. Not going to be particularly easy to do so. The Hound's Mound's so close, but we'll find a way. Life always finds a way. Are you fucking kidding me? We actually have forest to the side as well. I think it's just anywhere you catch the exclusives in these regions. Oh, okay. That makes them a lot less exclusive than I thought they were. Although I guess I don't like the idea of exclusives anyway, so... I don't know why I seem to be defending them. Fair enough. No! Go away! Thank you. You guys do not want to incur my wrath. Trust me. Just go back home. I will not find you. I will not pursue you.
But if you don't let my daughter go, I will find you. And I will kill you.
I will pursue you. I will find you. I will kill you. I don't remember the quote word for word.
God.
How much dodging am I gonna have to do here? God, just go back to your base. God. Come on. I thought it was I will end you. Could be. I'm oftentimes wrong. Okay. Nice. I will find you and I will kill you. See, I thought it was kill. But I'm not confident enough to stake money on it. Eat the food. Down here. Eat the food. God, they're so easy to kill. Stay away from me. I don't even need to fight you. Alright. Get one of these to spawn. Bunch of spiders around these days. If I have to go too close to the spiders to get this koalaphant to spawn, I'm just not gonna get it to spawn. Yeah, no, I actually have to go into the spider spawn to get them to... Yep, oh, well, guess I'm not doing that then. So I've left my fire staff over in the other area. And, like, a mostly used pickaxe, but obviously I'm not gonna begrudge that. There's so much gold here. Oh my god. The thing is, if tumbleweeds are spawning, this is actually the best camp location. If tumbleweeds aren't spawning, this is pretty bad. You know what? I'll make a nighttime camp. Just in the nick of time as well, apparently. Eat a bunch of these stale butterfly wings. Gotta get them before they rot. Might actually just finish off the stack, to be entirely honest. Yeah, the crank thing is in the other area. I do want a backpack before I pick it up, though. But the backpack will happen really, really quickly. Like, for example, this is how quickly it's gonna happen, right? I'm gonna make the science machine. It's arbitrary where I make the science machine. I'm just gonna put it down right here, right? Then there's the backpack. We go to refine 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 2 cut stone. And then we prototype the alchemy machine. Now we only need the alchemy engine to actually prototype all the rest of the stuff. So what is the next thing that I actually want to make? It might be in structures for birdcage. Birdcage requires an alchemy engine and apparently 2 seeds. Right. I'll wait for you to drop your seeds and then that'll be our birdcage actually. Come on, just one of you drop seeds, please. Any of you. I'm not gonna move anywhere near any of them. I'm just gonna wait for them to do it. Shovel's also quite important. There we go. Taking seeds. Got it. See, I don't want to be particularly close to the spiders, but also I want to be particularly close to a different terrain. Shit, that's a blow dart as well. Okay, that leads back in this direction, thankfully. Probably much easier to follow than any other. Shit, we might actually get a koalaphant that we can just instantly fight here. These go back in this direction. I must have picked up on a track that I was previously already going on. Are they gonna fight? Please fight. That'd be so good! Spiders would lose, and then I'd kill the koalaphant. Clean up. Okay, so this is probably where I put my final base. And that'll go there. Now we'll put down the alchemy engine directly. You know what? The alchemy engine can go inside. That's true. Now, for structures, we can create the birdcage. So this is actually going to allow us to do things with all of the monster meat that we're getting. We can use the monster meat just to make eggs. But in order to do that, we are going to need first a bird trap. And to make sure that we get something in that bird trap, we will bait it with those seeds. Beautiful. Okay. It's our bird already! Alright! Now the bird trap can actually catch things without having to have something in it, so... there's no need. There's our bird cage already filled. Beautiful. I do want to craft a spear just to know how to craft it. That said, I obviously already have my own tentacle spike here. It might be worth my while to craft a tent. Because sanity is going to be our biggest concern. And honestly, food is not going to be that bad. Originally, it looked like food was going to be the big problem. But it won't be too bad. At most times, I feel. That's it. Our next chore is definitely top hat. And maybe opulent axe? Opulent pickaxe? All of those kinds of things? See, after I get my science machines done, I always forget what gold is used for. I know it's useful, I just don't know what for, apparently. I'm not gonna cheat to get the character. If anything, getting Maxwell is kind of like ancillary. It's not the main purpose of this. The main purpose of this is playing adventure mode. The fact that I unlock Maxwell is just like a bonus. Hey. Get the rest of this gold. Can't tell you for the life of me what I'm trying to use it for. We should probably just try and prototype pretty much everything that exists. That said, I definitely need a regal shovel, because I'm going to try and replace all of these spiky bushes over near my base. Because that's going to be pretty much my source of twigs, right? Which is starting to make me a little wary about my usage of grass. So, while I may want to create a farm of trees and then burn them all down so that I can get charcoal and then use that charcoal to make drying racks, I can make maybe one drying rack, because a drying rack is 3 rope, and each rope is 3 grass. So that's almost half of my cut grass right there. It seems like tumbleweeds don't spawn. Which is sad news, but not entirely unexpected. Tumbleweeds are really fucking powerful. So for them to be in this mode might actually make it just too easy. Tumbleweeds are legitimately insane. Oh cool, there's poop over there. I was wondering, hang on, are there beefalo in this map? But no, it's not beefalo, it's the koalaphant that's pooping.
I think it's about the time to sleep, so see you next time. See you next time, buddy. Thanks for tuning into the stream. We need to easy off the loft attempts? Yeah, no kidding, I guess. Back into light for a second. It's another tree and run away. Beautiful. Besides, there are still maps after this, yeah. This is... I didn't, actually. Fuck. I'm gonna make myself a log suit here. Just for safety's sake. Yeah, now I can hear some munching going on in the background. Who knows what they'll bring? Apparently death and despair if this map is anything to go by. Food over here, and the log suit. I only got Maxwell on the PS4 for the achievement and trophy. You didn't get him to play Maxwell? It was like playing Maxwell might be the reward for unlocking Maxwell. Alright. Well, until we have to worry about it, let's not worry about the hounds. Until they are directly relevant to our life. So they should take 3 hits for me using the tentacle spike. I could possibly bait them into a wall with the spiders or something like that. Honestly, it might not be that difficult, actually. Well, he kind of made the game too easy. Playing Maxwell? Interesting. Alright, it looks like they're only interested in me. Stand at arms, then.
Stand and fight.
Easy. There are more that apparently just haven't come to fight me yet. Now, there's enough spiders that I'm not really worried about the sustainability of these spider dens. If I can take out a spider den, I probably just should. Especially considering I don't actually have tentacle spikes or anything like that in this map to help me. Pretty much just me v spider. So I'm mostly here for all of the monster meat. Because that alongside morsels that I can get. Oh! What the fuck? Oh, there is the pig hut, obviously. Obvious. Why am I so surprised by this? Anyhow. Piggy. Piggy are not difficult to kill. Beautiful. So the reason I kill the piggy is because I am trying to get off of his corpse the pig skin, and the pig skin will allow me to make a pig helmet, or rather football helmet, sorry. The football helmet is... combined with a log suit, around 90% damage protection, if I recall correctly. So it's really significant at that point. You look like Abraham Lincoln.
417 years ago.
Isn't that... Is this true, chat? Because I've heard this story many, many, many a time. Apparently, Abraham Lincoln was just, like, real ugly. And so his publicist was talking... Publicist is, I imagine, campaign manager. Was talking to people at a rally, and they said I could never vote for him. He's ugly as sin. So they made him grow a beard to hide it. That's just what I heard. Can't guarantee it is even slightly factual. In fact, since I heard it, I can guarantee most likely it isn't. Okay, that is the one that I didn't go into previously. Beautiful. Not a clue. Alright. All those sounds are gonna follow me. That is fine by me. That is fine by me. You know what? I'm actually gonna go down the safe path here. I'd say I've heard that one, but I also don't know much about Lincoln. Fair enough. But he was a kick-ass vampire slayer. Was that movie actually any good? Because I like cheesy romps as much as the next guy, but my kind of cheesy romp is like, I guess, Ash versus the Evil Dead, right? Or, you know, Evil Dead 2, and Army of Darkness. Pretty decent? Might actually have to consider going back to that one, then. Alright, first things first. Need to get these logs on this fire. And I'm actually gonna have to burn down this forest already. Like, it's a lot earlier than I was hoping to. Oh shit, I have a fire torch. Oh. Anyway, it's a lot earlier than I was hoping to do this. But it had to happen eventually. Why not now? Stream is coming to an end soon. That is true. That is definitely true. Keep getting called by someone, so I have to imagine that something important is being said. It's also entirely possible they just forgot when I stream. Okay, I just need enough charcoal to make one crockpot. That's it. That's all we need. Damn it. Stop trying to carry more stuff. You know what? If every single time I pick them up, I just immediately insta-plant them, I should be fine. Okay, enough to do what I want to do. Fine, you know what? Fight me. You're gonna fight me in the nighttime, you'll fight me in the nighttime. Let's go, we'll fight in the shade.
The arrows will block out the sun, then we will fight in the shade.
Where is my backpack? Beautiful. No, actually store it in the backpack, thank you very much. Okay, so now we are looking in the food inventory, down to crockpot, only 3 cut stone, easy as hell. Ready? Stack those over there. That'll do. Okay. So this is how this should work, if I recall correctly. If I cook this, you eat it, right? And you give me an egg. Beautiful. Then I cook another one. I'll put one in there. You give me the next egg. I open the trap for the bird, rebait it, of course.
And this will keep me alive for many, many years to come. Cooked morsel also goes in here. Plus both of these eggs in order to create... Bacon and eggs for 75 hunger and 20 HP. Far from bad, that. Far from bad. Okay, I also appear to have exactly 25 of these... Spiky bushes? No, 15. Why do I think I had 25? That's 23 more years, at the very least. I mean, I was hoping to last until I'm like 80 or something like that, but that's... I don't know. Apparently optimistic. Okay. I'm gonna make these for a 5x5 pattern. And just assume that I'm going... Wow. I have already made them off... You know what? Fuck it. If they're going to be off-kilter, they're going to be off-kilter. Yeah, okay. That is not okay with me then. This one. It's like the second one is off-kilter. God damn it, Ryan. Recollect yourself. They are one more space than they should be. That's the whole point of this. So I imagine when these come up, I actually just have to dig them back up again and replant them, rather than take the damage. I mean, it's either that or take the damage. I definitely have a preference there. I really think you have OCD because that's what I do. I don't. It's... not defensive, it's just like, it'd be really, really belittling of people who actually do struggle with OCD for me to say, I have OCD because I like things neat. No, I just like things neat. Give me that. Give me that eggs. Yeah, buddy. Alright. That'll be our next. And pretty much once a day, we're going to need to do that, right? Like, it's not going to be a very long period of time that we actually need to sustain. So, I guess for the rest of today, I'm going to get some more charcoal. Probably the best plan that I can make. And then maybe in the nighttime, aggro the koalaphant. Koalaphant's making a lot of poop, though. I'm relatively appreciative. Because if you make two more poops, I'll be able to prototype an advanced farm. Might actually be a good idea to just let him poop. Hey, that's actually one more poop. And there's the final one. You know what? Thank you. I really appreciate it, friendo. And now you must die. No good deed goes unpunished, friend. Time for you to run into the wall. Told ya. One, two, three, four. Got him! Tentacle spike is so good! Alright, we'll eat this just for the HP. And now we can create a meat effigy, if I recall. No, of course, we're going to need the Prestahatitator. Is the meat effigy from the Prestahatitator or the Shadow Manipulator? Let's see. Oh, only a Prestahatitator. Shit. We might be able to get that. Is ADHD a disorder? Well, I mean, it's attention deficit hyper disorder. Hyperactive disorder? I mean, I know the last word stands for disorder. So, I mean, semantically. Alright, that's our crockpot done then. So, pretty much, we've just got to wait for the morning. We are really in the midst of summer here. You can see because we've got, like, no nighttime at all. Just a bunch of daylight. Really, really good daylight.
I'm gonna fight some more spiders just because I can. It's kind of like that scene in The Matrix. Attention deficit hyperactive disorder, had it correct. Beautiful. Come on, spider. My tentacle spike just broke. That is horrible news. Is it worth my while to go to the previous world in order to get the tentacle spike again? I don't know. All I know is I still have spears, so motherfuckers better beware. Okay, I do need to fuel this still a little bit more. That should be fine. I think I can actually create a farm right now, right? Yep. There's an improved farm. Actually, just gonna chuck that up over here. And of course, of fucking course it's like that. Anyway, I only created that to get the schematic for it anyhow. So that schematic is gonna be available for all of the rest of time. Thermal stone is also a really useful schematic to have, so we'll drop that thermal stone just here. Any others that I can craft right now? Not really. But getting to the morning of this, I'm gonna go to save and quit and change over this screen. It's that time again, folks. We must part for a few days. I don't know what's gonna happen with Wednesday's stream. I can't tell you. The easiest way to... God, look at this hair disaster. Easiest way to find out what's going to happen with regards to Wednesday, if I can say the word correctly, Wednesday's stream is going to be to follow either Orbital or I or both of us on twitter.com/orbitalpotato or twitter.com/rhapsodyplays. Yeah, not certain if that'll have to be earlier, have to be moved, have to be shorter, have to be... I imagine it's not probably going to have to be longer as a result of the schedule. But we'll have to see what happens with that. Anyhow, let me just cut to the outro. Say thank you very much to each and everyone who turned up for any period of time, short or long, here since the start or here for the last 5 minutes. Thank you for joining. Hopefully you've been enjoying yourselves. And hopefully we'll see you next time.